We so so we have to talk about how we can get more Africans to be rich. This is what I've noticed. A lot of Africans, we don't like a lot, not all of you guys. Some of you are really amazing. We don't want others to be rich, and we don't want others to be successful, right? But I'm a different African. I hope we get to be more different Africans. I want to see more rich Africans and more successful Africans. Do you know what that means? If you have more rich, successful Africans, it means that my problems are going to be solved. It means that they're going to improve our communities. It means that there's going to be more circulation of money in our communities, which is definitely going to improve all of our communities in terms of like tourism. Just imagine if you have so many rich Zimbabweans, they're going to travel to countries like Mauritius, they're going to travel to South Africa, they're going to do all those tourism things in Botswana, they're going to be in Swaziland doing some fun things. So I want more rich Africans, because if they travel to Swaziland, they're doing more for the economy over there. You know what I'm saying? They travel to Botswana, they're doing more for the economy, and it's benefiting all of these Africans. So this is why I advocate for more rich Africans, and I try to encourage more Africans to get into entrepreneurship, because by owning a piece of business or owning a piece of equity, that's the way for you to become wealthy, like truly wealthy, right? So Africans will never get rich until we do this. Stop waiting on the government. The government will never change. If it changes, it's not going to do anything for you and for your life. Trust me, it might do something, but is it really going to change your life? Like, really? Think about it. All the things that you're complaining about right now, do you think they're going to change if there's a change in government? Some of them definitely will change, right? But not all of it is going to change. So here's what you need to do. You need to change yourself. In order to change your income, you have to change your understanding. In order to change your understanding, you have to change yourself. I just say something that's going to fly over a lot of people's heads, but I'm going to try to slow it down, okay? So we can understand each other. I have a problem when I communicate, I'm thinking I'm communicating with people that are like me, or at the same time, I'm communicating to somebody that doesn't know, that's worried about where am I going to get my next meal tomorrow? Where am I going to get money to pay for school fees for my kids, in the next semester or the next term. So here's what I'm saying. We shouldn't wait. There's no one who's gonna come and hand you out $1 million. Like, oh, you've been a great citizen. You've been very nice. You've been very, you've been praying so hard. There's $1 million. Just take it. Now you're rich, you and your family. $1 million is not a lot of money. And let's say $5 million. This is a year for you and your family. Now you're all rich. Go enjoy life. No one is going to do that for you. So, but meaning that, as I said, the government is not going to change. Nobody's going to hand out $5 million to you so you can become rich. So here's how you do it. Change your understanding, change yourself, change the people around you, okay? So change your understanding. How to change your understanding? Read more books on self-development, read more books on finances. Read this book, Rich Dad Poor Dad. Read this book, Think and Grow Rich by Napoleon Hill. And read all those books. Read this book, The Richest Man in Babylon. Those are my favorite books. Those are the books that really made an impact in my life. So just choose any from that list that I just mentioned. And there's a whole lot of books self-development books that you can get into that can help you to change yourself. So in order to change your life, you need to change yourself. You need to change your understanding. By changing your understanding, your income is going to change. But your mind is conflicted to what I'm telling you right now, but you need to try to see. You're poor right now, right? So I mean, it's not like you're doing anything better. So this is something I'm offering you to try, whether it's a bad idea or good idea. But do you have a better idea than the one I'm offering right now? I guess you don't. So develop yourself, self-development. So this is this is how you can change your life. So change your understanding. The government is not going to change. You have to change. You're the one who has to change. So once you change, your life is going to change. Amazing things are going to happen in your life. So you change yourself, the people around, when you definitely change yourself, the people around you are definitely going to change automatically, because you know what people you hang out with, to hang out with, and you know, you start attracting these amazing people into your life because of this amazing person you became. So that's about it, man. That's about it. So yeah, and I think this video today it's going to be short, and I can make a part two about this, but I think with most of my videos it always comes back to the same thing. So yeah, so I hope a lot of Africans are going to, you know, to change themselves and want to change ourselves. The money is going to come, and our lives are going to be better. I believe if I make one rich African, he's going to make somebody rich also. He's going to change his environment. He's going to go back to his village and build schools and educate people there. He's going to do amazing things, give clean water to people. It's just amazing things. So why not? Why not share the knowledge with fellow African brothers? I hope I get to change somebody else's life. If not, I mean, my effort is not wasted. I'll